And please welcome Tatiana Kimova, if I'm not mistaken, with the speech about the innovative breakthrough, first use case on OSDU with Total Energies. Please welcome.
Hello, hello, dear all. Thank you for staying with us. I know that a lot of people have to leave because of the plane constraints. So happy to see you here, and very happy to present you the topic: the innovative breakthrough, first use case in OSDU within Total Energies. So I'll present this topic today on behalf of Total Energies. I'm the data platform lead of OSDU team in Total Energies, and Baptiste Jude, he is a technical lead of OSDU team, and he will be happy to help me to answer your very technical questions that I'm sure we'll have at the end of the presentation. So we discussed a lot during the conference about the OSDU, and I'm sure that you know what is this. And let's quickly summarize why OSDU, and what are the main pain points we are facing in our current data ecosystem today. So the main pain points that the data is loaded in different databases, in different softwares, in different formats according to different data models. It's very complicated to share the data. It's very complicated to collaborate. It's complicated to collaborate inside the same company, but also with the third parties, with our partners, with the governments, and also this siloed ecosystem today, and we are really convinced about this. It is slow down the adoption of the new technologies and new softwares. So we believe that OSDU adoption will help to tackle these pain points. And our main purpose of this OSDU use case, which I'll present you today, is to show that OSDU may help to improve the collaboration between different métiers across different countries. So also it is the standardization, because this is a standard data model which is proposed and which is adopted by the softwares. Also it is the acceleration, so we know where the trusted data is stored, so this accelerates also the decision-making process. And all of these purposes of our use case were successfully achieved at the end of our development. So why we are talking the Surinam use case? So when we wanted to start this very first use case on the OSDU, so on which real use case we may do it. We didn't want to do the production use case in the moment, but our purpose was to show what are the advantages of the data platform which Total Energies may benefit from. So the Surinam use case, because it is a very visible project. So the block 58 here, it's a golden block, and the Surinam, Total Energies, the operator, and this is a transverse project between the exploration and the development. So the team was spread across different locations in Surinam affiliate. In Houston, we have the exploration hub there, and the France team in Paris and Pau. So multi-softwares, and I'll show you exactly which softwares we are talking about. It was a green field, so we have very limited legacy data, so it's better for the project. And the initial scope was really simplified. It was centered on the well data, the most mature data type within OSDU community today. And also we wanted to have the use case across different métiers, across the geoscience and the drills. So that's why Surinam use case was selected. So we worked on this project during more or less 10 months, and we delivered it in the end of September 2021. So we worked with different companies on this, and you can see here the main streams of our work. So first big stream, it was about the deployment and ingestion, so the framework stream. And we worked in close collaboration with Microsoft colleagues on the installation and the deployment on OSDU of the Mercury release in Total Azure platform on Inox secure environment. Also, we installed the ingestion framework. We worked with Viper colleagues on this at this time. We the second big stream, it was about the accessibility, the internal accessibility and also the external accessibility, because for us it was very important to show that the data platform adoption may help to accelerate to improve the data sharing with the partners and government. Also, the security aspect to be sure that the data platform, it is exactly in line with and compliant with our cybersecurity and confidentiality rules. The big, you can see here in the red on the slide, streams, it's about the connections. So about what connections we are talking about. The connections with our in-house interpretation software like SysMash, CEG. It is about the connections with the software Drillix for the well design. Before the drilling phase and the choose of the scenario for the trajectory for the drilling. Also, it is we worked in close collaboration with Emerson for the geolock connector for OSDU. And the, we did some custom developments in order to tackle the missing of data management tools on the top of the OSDU. So we developed the Dropbox, which allowed to ingest the well data directly on the data platform and also to share with the third parties. And finally, on the top of the OSDU, we installed the universal viewer, and we worked with is also in close collaboration with INT, with IVAP, which allow to have a view on the data which is ingested in the data platform and also to share the data with the third parties. So concretely, what was done? So as you saw before, why Suriname use case slide? So the scope of the project was really limited on the well data. So here you can see in which square, which data types is concerning in each connector. So you can see here that some of the softwares used the upload download principle, and some of them were directly plugged on the Azure. For SysMash, Adept, Geolog, IVAP, Dropbox, it was the well data. But for example, within SysMash and Adept, we use the exchange of the custom data type as well, the scenario, which we introduced ourselves in order to fit for our business need, as it is the aggregation of different data types, like the well location, trajectory, well marker targets, and pore pressure fracture gradient profile. So for Geolog connector, it allows today to consume the well log from the data platform in less format, so to do the interpretation and to send the data back in a less format and also the PDF plot. So for the IVAP, we tested the visualization of the well trajectories, of the well markers, of the well logs, and sharing with the third parties. As for the Dropbox, which allows us to ingest in the data platform the well trajectory and the well logs. So for all of this, we used the community APIs, and the overall strategy of the Total Energies is to be as standard as possible with the OSDU community code and the API proposed. So we used the wellbore DMS. We use the well planning DMS for everything related to the well design before the drilling phase. And also, as I said before, we introduced some our custom schemas for the scenario in order to fit to our business need. And this is also the advantage of the OSDU open code, that we may customize if it's needed for our business purposes. So for sure, also, it was a question about the entitlement model, which we would like to put on the top of OSDU data platform. So it was successfully done. We deployed the OSDU entitlement V2 model. And here you can see the schema. So with the access, which is granted to the third parties, to our partners, government, to the exploration or the development, and the team members. So the owners, the viewers, according to the entitlement model proposed. So let's have a look quickly in the IT architecture, high-level overview. So as we saw in the previous slide, so some of the applications which are connected to the data platform are on-premise. Some of them are already plugged directly and installed in Azure. And all the interactions inside the data platform and also interactions with the application is done by the OSDU community APIs. And also you can see here that there is a SysMash SaaS, which was in the Google Cloud. So also in this time, we tested the interoperability between different clouds. for this use case. So concretely, let's have a look what data business workflow we covered in the Surinam use case. So here you can see in this slide three main phases. So phase one and two, it is the pre-drilling phase. It's the preparation of the scenario for the drilling. It's very important here, this collaboration between the geoscientist and the drillers when they're exchanging the scenarios. So including the well location, well targets, well markers, and well trajectory, and pore pressure fracture gradient profiles. And this is the exchange between them in order to be sure what scenario is agreed, what is the validated planned trajectory. And this is done during these two phases, which we covered. And after, so drilling, after the scenario is agreed, the drilling phase begins. During the drilling phase, what happened? So during the drilling phase, we have to recover directly the data from the rig. So what we did, so here you can see the Dropbox application. You remember it's a custom application which we developed for this use case because of the data management need. So the on-site geologist from the rig, he dropped the data. We are talking here about the log data, log well drilling data, and directional survey on the platform, on the Dropbox. After the operational geologist, he has a look on the data and he validates the data. Once the data is validated, the ingestion mechanism is triggered and data arrives to the data platform. After the petrophysicist, he has to do the Russian interpretation. So he recovers the data directly from the platform using his geolog software. He's doing this, his interpretation, and he's pushing data back to the data platform. And after, we have our geoscientist. Our geoscientist would like to perform the follow-up of the well. So he will consume the data which was validated by the operational geologist in his interpretation project, and also he will recover directly from the platform the data, the Russian interpretation data, which was pushed by the petrophysicist. So this allows the real collaboration across different sites and across different métiers. And all in all, it's important to share the data with our third parties according to the contracts, and that's why here the IVAP and ENT also allow this possibility to share the trajectories, to share the logs with the third parties. So, and now I would like to show you the movie which we performed at the end of the Surinam use case, which will summarize why we are doing this use case, the feedback from the users, and also we will see all these three phases which I show you here on the slide, really how it's working in the applications. So let's start.
Cela fait maintenant 3 ou 4 ans que Total Energy s'intéresse de près à l'écosystème OSDU, comme d'ailleurs l'ensemble des opérateurs et sociétés de services de notre industrie. La première version opérationnelle, la R3 Mercury, a été livrée en mars et nous voulions la tester dans sa globalité pour démontrer le potentiel d'OSDU sur un cas très concret de travail collaboratif dans le domaine des géosciences et du forage. Le use case sur Inam est lancé.
Après avoir installé la plateforme cloud sur Microsoft Azure, il s'agissait de montrer la possibilité d'améliorer la collaboration entre les différents membres de l'équipe projet pendant les phases conceptuelles et engineering et considérablement réduire le temps de définition d'une trajectoire de puits. Pour cela, nous avons connecté 6 mages, adeptes, géologues et IVAP.
On SysMage, I can prepare the well targets, well location, well markers and well trajectories directly on OSDU as if I were on my local drive.
Avec Adept, je récupère sur OSDU la well target sélectionnée et je renvoie directement la trajectoire du puits, ce qui permet qu'elle soit disponible pour mes collègues sur SysMage.
So what is fantastic is that we can roll back through previous scenarios to compare all the preliminary well locations and well trajectories that were proposed.
Le code OSDU est open source, ce qui nous a permis de pouvoir apporter nos propres modifications pour gérer des cas concrets comme la gestion des scénarios.
Avec ce système, les données prennent enfin leur place unique et au centre des activités de science. Nos logiciels se connectent à la plateforme et peuvent accéder à chaque donnée validée sans échanger manuellement de fichiers. Ils sont accessibles directement à travers l'interface. C'est un vrai game changer.
Nous avons aussi simplifié la mise à disposition des données en phase forage. Chaque mesure sur le rig est validée sur la plateforme et ensuite rendue accessible à l'ensemble de l'équipe projet et à nos partenaires externes.
Bonjour, monsieur. Mon website m'a envoyé les données du rig hier et je viens de les valider. Vous devrez les avoir dans un instant.
Alors, sur Geolog, c'est bon, je les ai récupérés.
Et sur Sysmage, c'est bon pour moi aussi.
Je les ai aussi sur Adept. Merci Kenny, ben, on va regarder ça et on revient vers toi.
D'accord, du coup on est bon sur Geolog, Sysmage, Adept. C'est très pratique OSDU.
Nos partenaires externes bénéficient également d'un accès sécurisé aux données que nous devons leur partager contractuellement et qui sont accessibles et visualisables à la fois sur le Dropbox et sur l'EVAP.
Le processus d'élaboration des puits, que ce soit les puits d'exploration, d'appréciation ou même de développement, est toujours en soi un challenge. De par la pluridisciplinarité des équipes en charge, les processus opérationnels en jeu et la nature même des données. La plateforme de données nous a vraiment permis de réduire ces points de blocage en permettant de disposer d'une donnée à la fois validée, centralisée, accessible et par-dessus tout unique. C'est désormais possible et cette nouvelle plateforme contribue de fait à l'amélioration de notre performance opérationnelle collective.
Ce premier use case sur le Suriname était centré sur la donnée puits. Nous avons aussi ajouté de la donnée sismique en travaillant avec nos collègues de l'acquisition sismique, notamment en intégrant l'application PrestaTour. Mais le potentiel de la data plateforme ne s'arrête pas là. La communauté OSDU aujourd'hui, c'est plus de 200 compagnies, quelques 2000 ingénieurs et développeurs qui délivrent tous les jours des centaines de lignes de code pour couvrir au maximum les besoins du secteur de l'énergie. Subsurface, surface, stockage de CO2 et même nouvelles énergies comme l'éolien et le solaire. Vous l'avez compris, c'est un projet ambitieux autour de la technologie cloud et une nouvelle ère pour Total Energy dans la gestion de nos données.
And so you saw that this was the feedback of the users who was involved in the test period, also in the development period, and we received really 100% of positive feedback, and we consider that Suriname use case, our MVP, was a success. So what next after this first step on the OSDU journey? So now we would like to go in the real production use case. We would like to reuse the bricks which were developed during the Suriname use case and to show the real added value on OSDU in production. So we would like to add and connect more softwares and more data types. So being focused still on the well data. So, and one of the possible candidates for the new use case is Uganda, where we there is a great challenge to follow up of more than 400 wells. And also the another challenge here is, as we saw today, OSDU does not provide the data management tools on the top of OSDU. And if you would like the data platform to be manageable by the affiliate, for instance, it's a very important point. So we are also looking how we may simplify the daily life to our data managers who will be embarked on the OSDU journey. So that's all for the presentation, and I would like to thank all the companies which were involved in this big project, which we did during the 10 months. And for sure, I would like also to warmly thank the whole OSDU team in Total Energies. So thank you very much, and you are welcome for the questions.